Yes, the picture you're looking at right now is police car, Murrysville police car. We understand that the suspect is being transported by Murrysville police to an area hospital. He's been here for questioning for some time this morning. There you see another officer getting inside that vehicle. Now, a Westmoreland detective has indicated that there is at least one injury to the suspect, a cut on his arm or wrist. It's not immediately apparent if that happened during any of the stabbing incidents or whether it happened during the time that the suspect was taken into custody. They're inside that police car. You see authorities leaving, just a shadow of a figure of a teenager in the back seat, silhouetted by the bright light here. The car pulling down the driveway from Murrysville police, again going to an area hospital. So to recap, the suspect, who Westmoreland authorities confirmed earlier was a fellow student of the victims, was taken into custody, was brought here for some time. A paramedics van was parked here outside as the questioning by authorities continued. A Westmoreland detective indicating that there was at least some injury to the suspect, indication of a possible cut on an arm or wrist, not any indication of whether or not that happened during a struggle, during the time when the suspect was taken into custody, or whether it was self-inflicted. We do know that authorities are, at this point, not releasing the name. There are information out there, but there's nothing been officially confirmed about the identity or the condition of the suspect. But as you saw live just moments ago, that Murrysville police car exiting this Murrysville police headquarters, where the questioning of the young student has been going on for some time. As we get more information from police concerning the identity, the circumstances, we will be passing that on to you. Reporting live at Murrysville Police, Bob Mayo, Pittsburgh's Action News 4.